Chapter 5, Chapter 3, Repentance. Page 29. One ray of the glory of God, one gleam of the purity of Christ, penetrating the soul, makes every spot of defilement painfully distinct and lays bare the deformity and defects of the human character. It makes apparent the unhallowed desires, the infidelity of the heart, the impurity of the lips. The sinner's act of disloyalty in making void the law of God are exposed to his sight, and his spirit is stricken and afflicted under the searching influence of the Spirit of God. He loathes himself as he views the pure, spotless character of Christ. When the prophet Daniel beheld the glory surrounding the heavenly messenger that was sent unto him, he was overwhelmed with a sense of his own weakness and imperfection. Describing the effect of the wonderful scene, he says, "There remained no strength in me, for my comeliness was turned in me into corruption, and I retained no strength." Daniel chapter 10, verse 8. The soul thus touched will hate its selfishness, abhor its self-love, and will seek, through Christ's righteousness, for the purity of heart that is in harmony with the law of God and the character of Christ. Paul says that, as touching the righteousness which is in the law, as far as outward acts were concerned, he was blameless, Philippians 3 verse 6, but when the spiritual character of the law was discerned, he saw himself a sinner. Judged by the letter of the law as men applied to the outward life, he had abstained from sin, but when he looked into the depth of his holy precept and saw himself as God saw him, he bowed in humiliation and confessed his guilt. He says, "I was alive without the law once, but when the commandment came, sin revived, and I died." Romans chapter 7 verse 9. When he saw the spiritual nature of the law, sin appeared in its true hideousness, and his self-esteem was gone. Step to Christ. Page 29, July 11th.